Why are fast tokenizers called fast? In this video, we'll see exactly how much faster the so-called fast tokenizers are compared to their slow counterparts. For this benchmark, we'll use the Glue MNLI dataset, which contains 432,000 pairs of text. We'll see how long it takes for the fast and slow versions of a BERT tokenizer to process them all. We define our fast and slow tokenizer using the auto-tokenizer API. The fast tokenizer is the default when available, so we pass along useFast equal false to define the slow one. In a notebook, we can time the execution of a cell with a time magic command like this. Processing the whole dataset is 4 times faster with a fast tokenizer. That's quicker indeed, but not very impressive. This is because we passed along the text to the tokenizer one at a time. This is a common mistake to do with fast tokenizers, which are backed by Rust, and thus able to parallelize the tokenizations of multiple texts. Passing them only one text at a time is like sending a cargo ship between two continents with just one container. It's very inefficient. To unleash the full speed of our fast tokenizers, we need to send them batches of texts, which we can do with the batch equal true argument of the map method. Now those are impressive results. The fast tokenizer takes 12 seconds to process a dataset that takes 4 minutes to the slow tokenizer. Summarizing the results in this table, you can see why we have called those tokenizers fast. And this is only for tokenizing text. If you ever need to train a new tokenizer, we do this very quickly too.